Let us start with a very, very small act, the payment of bonus act. Do you know, when you are managing a company, what is more difficult? Managing the resources like money, managing the resources like material, or managing the resources like human beings? Which is the most difficult thing, managing the resources like human beings? Just see this, you will get an understanding how difficult it is to manage human beings. So now what did we understand from this? What did we understand from this? If the employee is not working, at last what you should do? What is that we understand from this? It is very, very, very difficult to manage an employee. It is very, very difficult to motivate an employee. You can have n number of techniques, but all the techniques which suits one employee will not suit the other employee. But there is one technique which will suit all the employees. What is the technique? Motivating them with money. This technique will suit across all the employees, right from a layman, right from a normal worker, till a very, very dignified professional. Money will motivate all these persons. There are different ways of using this money to motivate people. That is what we are going to see next. How money can be used to motivate the people. Modes, or what are the mechanisms in which I can use money to motivate the people? Bonus. Because the topic which I am going to start is? Obviously. Other you should say first. Bonus. Abram. Increment. Incentive. Promotion, perquisite. Next, sir, allowances, whatever words you have used it. Then, salary is not a motivation, sir. Salary is the basic remuneration for the work we is doing. There are various non-financial factors relating to motivation that I will discuss some of those. But I am not going to discuss all the non-financial factors here, because the non-financial factor of motivation is a separate study. That is what they read it as, human resources. There is a separate study, management of human resources. We are not going to deal with that. Being finance professionals, we will be dealing how to motivate an employee financially. Non-financial factor, let to quote one or two, for example, If an employee is performing well, why people perform well? One, to get a monetary satisfaction. Number two, to get a mental satisfaction. When a person will get a mental satisfaction, if an employee has performed well, in the local newspapers given advertisement, my employee has performed like this. My employee has gone to abroad, he has completed this research and he is coming back. Now what the employee will feel? He'll feel proud, he'll be happy. Response, sir.
Yes,
like this. Suppose if an employee is doing something on a small scale, not on a very large scale, small scale, an employee is completing a report on time. Don't call that employee and appreciate the employee. Go to the employee's place, go to the employee's work cabin and call the employee and appreciate him in front of all the other employees. Now also he will feel motivated, yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Like this, there are various modes of motivating an employee in non-financial matters. That is not the subject matter of our study. Being finance professionals, we will be interested in how to motivate an employee financially. Right? Number one, promotion. As you all know, salary increment or hike, fringe benefits. I will take care of your family, mates. I will provide education facilities to your
children.
Wife. I'll provide some educational facilities. I will provide some assistance. You want a servant to take care of your household things, I'll appoint a servant. Motivated or not?
Yes, sir.
Obviously, you'll be motivated. So, you provide some fringe benefits to him, stating that I will take care of you. Sorry, I will take care of your family. You take care of my organization. Next, performance related pay, commissions, etc. Next, sharing profits. So, give him bonus and then give him a commitment today that I will take care of your tomorrow. What is this? Give him a promise. Come on, today you work well in the organization. Even after retirement, I will take care of you. How I will take care of you? Provide you pension, provide you gratuity, provide you provident fund. I will take care of you. So give him a commitment today that you will take care of us tomorrow. And the last one is, give him the owner's feel. How will you give an employee the owner's feel?
Freedom.
Profit share. By giving him equity shares. Sir, you have learned some concept or have you heard about some concept? Sweat equity shares. Employee stock option scheme. Listen. As I told you, very difficult to motivate an employee. I am an employer. You are an employee. I come to office sharp at 11 o'clock. I leave the office sharp at 5 o'clock. You come to office sharp at 9 o'clock. You leave the office sharp at 9 o'clock. What will be your feeling? Are you? Bloody tall fellow. From morning 9 o'clock to evening 9 o'clock, I am working for you. But what are you doing?
Coming
by 11 o'clock, going by 4 o'clock or 5 o'clock, that too many days, holidays, too many days, outstation visit. I am working for you so much. You are not working for yourself. You are just taking away the entire blood and flesh out of me and you are minting so much of money. So now what I say, sir, you work more, I will give you a share in my profits. If you work more, I'll earn more profits. If I earn more profits, you will get more share in the profits, bonus. But sometimes, after a point of time, finance will not be the motivating factor. After one particular point of time, the employee will say, sir, enough of all these finances, sir, enough of all these financial factors. The more and more amount you give to me, the more and more tax burden falls on me. So I don't want these financial factors. Do something else, sir. Now I tell him, all these days, I were your boss. From today onwards, I am your boss and you are my boss. How? Partners? Sir, tell me who are the owners of the company? Who are the owners of the company? Who is managing the affairs of the company? Board of directors. Sir, I am a board of director. I am the boss and you are my worker. Yes or not? Now all of a sudden I say, sir, you work more, I will give you shares. Now the moment I give you shares, you become the owner of the company. You become my boss and I also become your boss. Yes or not?
Yes,
so this is one of the other way of motivating an employee. So these are some of the financial factors of motivating an employee, of which now we'll be focusing only on this term bonus. We'll be discussing about this bonus now. Right. A brief history on this bonus, how this bonus came into existence. It was during the First World War time. The practice of paying bonus in India appears to have originated during the First World War, when certain textile mills granted 10% of wages as war bonus to their workers. And then in the year 1950, the Labour Appellate Tribunal, it evolved a formula for a determination of bonus. So the history is very simple. It is the textile mill owners who started the habit of paying the bonus. Once these textile mill owners, they started making this bonus payment, across all the industries, every employee, they started asking, sir, for me bonus, sir, for me bonus, they started asking. Every employer had to devise a separate scheme for payment of bonus. Food division, he had to devise a separate scheme. Then these textile mills, they had to evolve with a separate scheme. So the government felt, instead of each employer evolving a separate scheme for payment of bonus, let the government enact a simple act called as Payment of Bonus Act. Once it becomes an act, who should follow? Everybody should follow. Yes or not?
Yes, sir.
Right. Now, we will get into the topic to its core depth. Any act you read, for that matter, the first two sections are very, very important. Can you tell me section 1 speaks about what? Section 1 of the act speaks about what? Name of the act. Scope of the act. Applicability of the act. Learn this. Section 1 speaks about the scope of the act and the applicability of the act. When I say applicability of the act, it speaks about two applicability. Number one, date applicability. Number two, it is area applicability. So three things are governed by the section 1. One is the scope, the other is the date applicability, and the other is the area applicability. Sorry, scope, what will be there? What will be there in scope? Scope will tell you what is the purpose of the act. For what this act came into existence, that will be there in the scope. Partnership Act. Tell me, what is the scope of Partnership Act? To regulate the relationship between partners. Companies Act. What is the scope of the Companies Act? To regulate the companies, to protect the investors, to protect the shareholders, to protect the creditors. Response, sir.
Yes,
sir. Upper scope of the act, it says what is the purpose for which the act comes into existence. That is what you call as scope of the act. Now tell me, payment of bonus act, for what it came into existence? To regulate the payment of bonus. Upper two more things you are having, a date applicability and area applicability. What does this year signify? What does this year signify? The year in which the act was passed. So what is the scope of this POBA? To regulate the payment of bonus. What is the applicability? Whatever I write here, I expect you to write. What is the applicability? applicability, two applicabilities are there, date applicability and area applicability. What is the date from which this act is applicable? It is applicable from 25th September 1965. This act is applicable from 25th September 1965. What is the area to which this act is applicable? Can you make a guess? It is applicable to whole of India, including Jammu and Kashmir. So unlike your contract act, here it is applicable to whole of India including Jammu and Kashmir. Any act, don't close your eyes and then say it is excludes Jammu and Kashmir. No, every act will specify whether this is applicable to Jammu and Kashmir or it is not applicable to Jammu and Kashmir. This payment of bonus act is also applicable to Jammu and Kashmir. This is the first thing which you should learn. Next, any act you take for that matter, one more section is very, very important. Section 2. Section 2 deals with what? Definition. Section 2 deals with definition. Right. Definition I am not covering here. I will come later. As and when I am going to discuss some words, I will come to the definition and then I will discuss the definition.